Top cats, man. Shout out Rough House, man. The most comfortable interview I could ever do is with them.
Right off top, man. What was the whole Pan Am experience like? If you had to sum it up in your own words.
Mini niggas on your payroll. Rich gang bangers, y'all ain't even know they make those. Double case lows. Push buttons, I gotta say so.
It was a good experience. Great experience. Bam.
Ain't a real street nigga unless you got a code. Might as well come a nigga followed by a lot of O's. In the back of the back.
From it, I feel like I was definitely leveled up after this fight. Especially being that this is one of the biggest fights of my life. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
I got it. I feel like I had it. But you know what I'm saying? It is.
Taking pictures like we rich and po. Another rich rap nigga, word to Ricky Rose.
He made that music.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Got KD in here, man. Yo, man, how you feeling though, man? How you feeling though?
Well, I'm good. I'm straight. I'm ready to fight, for real, for real.
That's what's up. That's what's up.
Yeah, ready to get right back at it. I'm still in shape. I ain't even let off.
Yeah, I seen you right back at it when y'all went home. I seen you trying to steal.
Yeah, hell yeah, I mean, shit. Cause shit, the world's right there, so it's like, man, there's no reason for me to back off right now, you know what I'm saying? So,
I like to hear that, you know what I'm saying? Keep it sharp.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, everything kind of happening fast. For the people, break down what the World Championship is for.
World Championship is like it's really a step of the Olympics. It's bigger than what I just fought in. This is every country going to. And this year, me had to qualify for it. We had to, it's an open. Every country to go to Worlds and shit, you know, qualification. So, this is really a step of the Olympics. So, it was an Olympic qualifier, but I even got suspended and they changed the rules. So we might have qualified for Olympics next year, but the Worlds is most definitely a big test for them.
That's what's up. Hey, and for everybody that don't know, you know what I'm saying, the homie Keyshawn just came from the Pan Am Games, you know what I'm saying? Represented USA, you know what I'm saying, represented us well down there, you know what I'm saying? Hey, I got a question. Hey, can I go ahead and jump into the top?
Yeah, turn up.
That's what's up. Hey, right off top, man. What was the whole Pan Am experience like? If you had to sum it up in your own words, what was the whole experience like? You know what I'm saying? In the ring, outside of the ring, the being down there. You know, yeah, what was the whole experience like?
It was some good experiences. Mm-hmm. Great experiences. Bam, say that right there.
Okay.
It was also it was also a lot of learning experiences too. You know what I'm saying? So looking back at the Pan Ams, I can say I learned a lot from it. Like even with the loss, even with things outside of the ring and inside the ring. You know what I'm saying? I learned a lot from it. I feel like I most definitely leveled up after this fight. Especially being that this is one of the biggest fights of my life. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I got it. I feel like I had it. But you know what I'm saying? That's what it is. Go back to the drawing board.
Already. Hey, well, give me one of the good experiences.
Yeah, turn up, man.
You know what I'm saying? We sit here, we want to know about the experiences.
After the first fight, you know what I'm saying? You know, all my peoples was out there, so they had an Airbnb out there, decent-sized crib, so we all, you know what I'm saying, kicked it out there, my people after the fight. Because I had like a two-day break after I fought. You know what I'm saying? I was supposed to fight three times, I fought twice. I guess the first guy pulled out or whatever the situation was. So after Trinidad, I fought him. So me and my people was kicking it. Man, shit.
Was you down there like a superstar?
I was eating what I want, put it like that. My weight was not a problem.
Yeah.
For real.
Hey, break it down, the whole experience. I see you had the whole fam out there too.
Yeah, man. I mean, fighting. Just fighting fighting that experience and in that crowd, especially the first fight, only people I could hear was my people. Saying
because
they deep, first of all, it's like
yeah.
a good
help
up.
Hey, ESPN kept turning the camera on them too.
And yeah, that's a special one. That's a, yeah. I hear them the whole fight. You know what I'm saying? So I really like it was really like crazy. For like, I never experienced nothing like that. It's hard to explain it. You know what I'm saying? So that was most definitely like.
Was it motivating or did it have you like, damn, I gotta win. I can't let them down.
I be like, I gotta win. Yeah, like, I gotta win. My grandma told me, I don't think I'm gonna fight. She's like, man, you'll kick your tail this time. I'm gonna get ready to kick your tail myself.
Hey, shout out to grandma.
Nah, but she said after the fight, I did good though. She proud of me.
She was
mad at Cuba.
Hey, when you pulled the curtain back. When you stepped out and you pulled the curtain back and you saw the crowd, I'm talking about the energy in there was crazy, nigga. I'm talking about, I'm running, I'm trying to get ready. I'm like, oh, they about to fight.
Real talk, hey, man, hey, nigga, I had to cook a big meal like it was a pay-per-view coming on, you know what I'm saying? Hey, a whole block fam, we were on the phone with each other right before the fight. Hey, man, KD don't care about? Hey, not yet, man, he's getting ready to come on, man. So the whole fam, you know what I'm saying, whole block fam. We tuned in and watched.
I love that energy, man. But back to the question. Honestly, man, when I walked in that stadium, I honestly expected it to be like that. Leading up to the fight week, basically, I just keep hearing everybody talking about it. People hitting my DM from other countries, like, man, that fight, you and Andy Cruz fight is gonna be like another GGG and Canelo. I'm like, dang, I'm glad you look at me like that. Thank you. But yeah, I'm like, man, so. I see the crowd, I wasn't really surprised, but when I was fighting and I really ain't hear nobody but just noise. That was the first time that ever happened. Like, I just heard nothing but noise. That was like everything was blocked out, couldn't hear nothing. So that's how I was like, that was a big experience for me, you know what I'm saying? So the crowd was definitely crazy. I knew that for a fact. And then people back at home was telling me, like people on Snapchat, recording how they was, like watching the fight. Like, man, people really like watched and supported.
I don't know if I'm getting ahead of top on this one, man, but I was gonna say, man, when I was watching the fight, bro, I noticed from the opening bell, you came out and you were in attack mode. You know what I'm saying? Step to that dude, took the fight to him. Was it your plan to come out in attack mode like that?
My game plan was to step to him.
Break it down. Wait. Break it down.
I ain't gonna lie to you, my game plan was to step to him. Because I feel like mentally, that was gonna break him down. You know what I'm saying? Little did I know, he was a little bit tougher than I thought. So it took a little longer for him to start breaking down. It took harder for me. But really what I should have done was just box me.
Hey, I'm gonna keep it all the way funky with you, bro. I think the way you came out, especially in that first round, bro, I think you had a lot of success taking that fight to him.
Thanks.
You know what I'm saying? And I done watched that fight a few times, man. And that's the one thing that jump out at me every time I watch it. It's like, yo, he was handling that dude. You know what I'm saying? When he came out, man, with that eye of the tiger and all of that. You know what I'm saying? Like, hey, nigga, I'm finna bring it to you. I don't know if you want it, but I'm finna bring it to you, man. So, I think the game plan that you came out with, you know what I'm saying, was worth it. So just from a spectator's point of view.
Yeah, I second that though. See, fucking with them Cubans, especially the first fight. When you go back and watch the first fight, it was like a feel like it was super technical. Both of y'all skilled fighters, so it's gonna be a lot of thinking in the ring.
Yeah.
When you step to him, I say, damn, Cruz ain't expect that. Mm-hmm. Even when I was walking out from the first round, I said he wasn't ready for this. He know he fucking with a whole nother, you know what I'm saying? This type of fight. And so when you was aggressive with him and everything, I'm like, that's how you gotta do him, cause he wanna sit there and be pretty and shit. Fuck all that, ho, we finna mix it up. You know what I'm saying? When you was on it, he ain't had no inside game neither. I said, man, he can't fuck with him inside. And I know y'all be out there on that inside game.
Yeah, man, I watched the fight. I was like, man, I should have kept rolling into him, working my insides on him. Like, because he won't touch for the inside at all.
Man. He ain't want no problem. He was wrapping up and everything. If you come in, he gonna clinch. He ain't want no smoke on the inside.
Yeah, only time he wanted smoke on the inside was when he caught me the right hand.
And
yep.
Let's break it down since you brought that up.
Hey, whoa. We can't get into that yet. Hey, let me ask you this, man.
So you
going back and you looked at the fight, right?
Yeah.
All right. So what do you think were your most effective punches in that fight? Okay. Bro, I thought your 1-2 was pristine, bro.
You couldn't miss with that motherfucker.
But,
man.
Bro, when he shoot that jab and come and follow it up with that straight right, bro, especially when he was trying to, like, duck over, you know what I'm saying? He duck over, like, to his left side or whatever, or his right side, whichever, bro, but you would catch him every time with that 1-2. Damn. I was like, yeah.
I like what you talk about, but you know why I say my jab, though?
What's that?
That was consistent.
Yeah, it was.
So it gotta be my jab, you know what I'm saying?
You need them jabs with them
Cubans. I feel like my most clear punches though would've, I should've kept, probably kept going them shots like that, you feel what I'm saying?
Yeah. Cause you could, bro, you could not miss with that 1-2.
Nah, you know? Nah, we were sitting there counting them hoes. You know what I'm saying? Hey, but watch this here too. Cruz a skilled fighter, man. He don't keep his head on the center line. He moving. He always showing different angles.
Yeah, he is
always throwing faint.
Great amateur fighter.
Mm-hmm. Break it down. What's the what type of mentality? What was the mental aspect? What was the mental experience like being in the ring?
That moment.
Yep.
I was very excited. Anxious. I say more anxious than excited, though. But those part of the two, though. Anxious, excited.
You was ready to get it.
I was very, very confident. Like, that was the first time my confidence was that high, on that level, and I didn't pull it out. So, like, that's like something I had to look at, like, hey, what happened? You feel me?
Right.
Check this out. Do you think it was some favoritism or something like that going on? Because, hey, man, they didn't show Team USA no love. I'm talking about they didn't show Team USA no love. The announcers and shit.
Can I say some facts real quick?
Turn up.
The finals day O'Shea fought was Thursday. She was the only USA person fighting that day. She won. No Cubans for that day. The next day? All the boy Cubans fought.
Yeah.
All them won. And no USA people won. It was four of us in that day.
Yeah.
Four. And no USA win. Every Cuban won.
Hey man, speaking of that, man, let me ask you this. and I was talking to the fam about this one, man, because when I went back and I watched Hugh Cruz's first fight, and one thing I noticed was, like, when he would get a punch in, he would always throw his hand up in the air, just kind of let the judges know, hey, I got one. You know what I'm saying? Do you think the judges kind of get hypnotized with that?
KD be throwing his hand in the air, goddamn.
Yeah, I noticed in that second fight, man, I started seeing KD hand going up too. Like, yeah, I got that nigga. I got it.
Hey, you know what? Hey, KD hit that nigga with a 1-2, and he raised his hand. He got hit and he raised his hand. You know what I'm saying? So maybe it's just instinct.
Maybe, nah, it don't instinct. Maybe, I don't know. The judge be believing that shit, man. I can't believe it. Well, I be doing this. You got to fight by the system. That's what my big brother said. Fight by the system. And the amateurs is not about who better. It's about who look better for the judges.
Yeah.
It's not about who better fighter.
Yeah, because I'm sitting up here thinking, like, if they didn't see a punch land, but they saw Cruz or whoever throw his hand up, do they go ahead and say, oh, okay, he must have got him. He raised his hand like that.
They
you know?
Like, dude, amateur boxers, amateur judges.
Yeah. Real talk. That's what's up. Right, all right. Real talk.
Hey, all right, take it. Big bro. Go ahead. Speaking of your big bro, what's up with Keon and Kel, man?
Man, my brother Kelvin, you know, he just got out of camp. He's going to Peru. So he was just up here training with me.
Yeah, I think that.
He got the Olympic trials qualified.
October,
Ohio.
Yeah,
that's what's up,
yeah,
man.
Hey, we got some people out there in Ohio, man. I'm gonna see if they can go out there. If they can go out there, we got some people out there in Ohio.
I'm going.
Yo, you turn it up.
Yeah, I'm going.
Stop.
I'm going, right? It's right at the world.
What about Keon? What he got coming up, Nick?
You know, Keon just had surgery.
Oh, yeah. Damn. I was going to ask you about that.
Shoulder, he'll be back. He'll be back right in January.
I seen him out there in Spain. Keon, he really like a top dude, man. A lot of people know him. Like the little young amateurs and shit I be talking. They be knowing who Keon is. The ones around his age.
Yeah, but it's a lot of old heads that
sleep
on Keon.
Yeah, we see his generation. They fucking with it.
Yeah,
you know
it is his generation, but a lot of old heads, like I say, like my generation, a little bit older than my generation, they think he are just a regular young boy.
Why you think that is?
I don't know, but I know what Keon is though. So
yeah,
but Keon be turning people's heads. I mean, like, yeah.
You say I knew that. I already knew that.
Yeah. I seen him out there in Spain.
Hey, well, check this out, man. I want to go back to the fight for a second, man. And I'm going to go where Top Cat was getting ready to go a little bit ago, man. But, all right. Now, in the third round, he caught you with a nice shot. Take us through what was going through your mind, you know what I'm saying, when that took place throughout the rest of that round, throughout the rest of the third round.
All right. This is all facts right here. So, when he hit me, I didn't even know I was hurt. I just think I got hit. Boom, I got hit. So when he started rushing me, I was like, all right, let me just get right real quick, slow him down. And I know he got momentum, you know what I'm saying? So I'm going back, got tangled up. But then, after like the ref broke it up, everybody, a part where the ref broke us up, after we got tangled up, we rushed in again, and I put my hands up, and my legs had buckled. I'm in my head like, oh snap, I'm hurt. So at that moment, that's what I'm like, oh, I'm hurt. So this time I try to hold him. Somehow he slipped out of me. I'm on the ropes. Remember that part when I was on the ropes and I leaned back twice?
Yeah.
That was that part. I was like, man, like I'm hurt. So I leaned back twice and rolled into him. So like that whole process, I'm like, all right, man, just recover that, recover. Like fighting back, still holding, fighting back, still holding. But like those are the like most important moments that I had to like tighten up mentally or fight going over. You know what I'm saying?
Real talk. All right, follow up real quick. All right, the fact that you took that shot and you still kept going, do you think that says anything to the people about your chin, your composure, your resiliency?
I mean, the chin speaks for itself, but. I feel like it speaks a lot about myself, how bad I really wanted it.
Yeah.
Third round, all on the line, Keyshawn pulled it out, get hit with a shot. And I still feel like I pulled it out and it's still up for discussion. I feel like that shows a lot about myself in the three round fight.
Right.
So, looking at the bigger picture,
that's just yeah.
How much people got to look for. The future.
Yeah, and because one thing that stood out to me, bro, was during that little time period, bro, is that you stayed composed. A lot of cats would have panicked in that, you know what I'm saying, in that situation, that predicament, man.
Okay.
But you stayed composed. Like you said, man, you did what you had to do to recover, whether it was, you know what I'm saying, slipping, whether it was clinching, whatever the case may be, but you stayed composed and you stuck to the game plan on what you do when you find yourself in trouble, man. So, hey, I commend you for that, man, for keeping your composure, you know what I'm saying, and working like a real G up in there, man.
Yeah, I appreciate that, man.
Hey, no bullshit, though. You
Real talk.
Hey, when you say when you had dealt back twice and when you came back into him, I said, all right, yeah, all right. You know what I'm saying? But you said you was hurt. But I'm looking at it, I said, he all right. You know what I'm saying? So, and when y'all got in the center, y'all went to the other corner, he started clinching. So I said, all right, he all right then. You know what I'm saying? You still was throwing combinations too.
Yep.
Yeah, he didn't want to follow up. He ain't even want to. You know what I'm saying? Because he probably was. Well, you was still
got,
stupid.
Still got
heat.
Yeah,
man. He knew you was still dangerous.
Yeah. Man, when you stepped out, is it personal between you and Cruz, though? You know what I'm saying? Hey, everybody already talking about the shit. You know what I'm saying?
Everybody on the block want to know, bro, because we saw after the fight was over, y'all went and congratulated each other's corners and shook your trainer's hands, and then y'all came back and like brushed each other off with your elbows and all of that. You know what I'm saying? We was like, oh, okay, it's like that.
Yeah. Shut up.
Hey. Personal not the word.
Okay.
Yeah, say this, goddamn. Yeah.
Real talk.
But hey. I'm gonna play it out. Professionally.
There you go.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Will Cruz be at the world?
Nah. Already.
Hey y'all, hear that shit, huh? It's going
down. Oh, we looking to get some get back.
Hey, man, we getting that round 10, man. We getting round 10, man, at the Worlds, man.
Sounds like all that amateurs, cute and stuff. He's not ready.
How old is Cruz?
He's 27.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Hey, what's your thoughts on that? These other teams, man, they been there with grown men, man. Team USA basically coming in there with teenagers. You know what I'm saying?
My boy Troy Osley was on the team fighting at Worlds at 18. I was 19 fighting Lazaro, Tiger, 19, 18 in the Worlds. Duke was 19 and he won silver at the Worlds. Like, we a new team developing. You know what I'm saying? We just now jumping into waters competing with guys that been in these waters. You know what I'm saying? People not looking at that part. They just looking at Cuba.
Yeah, no, man. Break it down, man. Because this is what I be trying to tell them, man. Break it down.
Man, straight like that. Like, we, I've been on TV for 2 years. This is my second year fighting internationally, traveling and stuff like that. Cubans got like over 300 fights. They got like 300 fights. They 25 and plus. The heavyweight is 29 years old. He fought freaking Anthony Joshua in the Olympics.
Yeah.
Our Lazaro 28. Andy Cruz 27. The Cuban Troy fought about like 26. Like, they all grown men with kids and all that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
we kids. You feel what I'm saying? That's how we kid. And we compete. Like, we really, really win it. Real, for real.
Check this out, man. I'm going to switch gears a little bit, man. I'm gonna ask you this, man. We know that you and your brothers, y'all got DB3 going on. So for everybody that's out there that's watching this, man, and that's gonna watch it later, man, give us a little breakdown on what DB3 is, and then I want to know where is DB3 at in its development right now.
DB3 is an enterprise. Later on, we got to turn pro. Look forward to turning to promotion and stuff like that. Right now, still in the developing part stages. We still getting everything under constructed. I mean, still constructed and stuff like that. So it's still developing, but most definitely, sometime by, I say winter time, January, it should be up and running. And the manufacturing shirts. And sweatsuits and stuff like that. Man, shout out Top Cats, man. Shout out Rough House, man. The most comfortable interview I could ever do is with them, man. And they just, you know what I'm saying, some great people to chill around, be around. You know what I'm saying? Who wouldn't want to be up here? You feel what I'm saying? Shout out to y'all too, man.
FP Blockfam, already.
Tell me what you crib worth. I hear you talking war, but have you lived first? I'm just here to keep it real, not make you feel worse. Maybe a lost cause, but I still search. Until the day I die holding my gun shot. Rather have a friend or enemy, which one am I? Fuck a bird box, I wanna see my brother fly. No longer shackled in chains, young nigga crucified. Walking down the block, holding my boom box. Optimistic, dirty nigga, clean tube socks. They gon' keep us in the ghetto till we move out. And we need some better books off in that schoolhouse. Rose rich weather, rich dirty nigga, it took so much effort. I don't give a fuck about who sold more records. Being self-made give me so much leverage, boss.
Ooh, got money, got woman, got cash, I'ma spend it out. You made back all dinner, but you see how you live. Ooh, was a nice day, yes.
Niggas on your payroll. Rich gangbangers, y'all ain't even know they make those. Double case loads, push buttons, I got say so. When it's war time, never lay low, y'all play roll.